In this video, we'll show how to install the Microsoft Windows 2012 R2 operating system in UEFI mode by using Dell Lifecycle Controller on a Dell-EMC 14th generation PowerEdge system. Before you begin, ensure that you have the Microsoft Windows Server 2012 R2 operating system ready. To begin the process, turn on the system. Now click Virtual Media, and then click Connect Virtual Media. The Initializing Connection dialog box is displayed. Press F2 to go to the System Setup page. Click System BIOS and then click Boot Settings. Ensure that UEFI is set as a boot mode. Click UEFI Boot Settings and then click UEFI Boot Sequence. Now make the virtual optical drive as your next boot device and then click OK. Click Back, Finish, and then click Yes to save the changes. Click Finish to exit the System Setup page and then click Yes to reboot the system. Now, press F10 to go to the Lifecycle Controller, click OS Deployment. Note that if you have the Dell OEM Recovery DVD Media, insert it into your DVD drive and continue with the Lifecycle Controller wizard. If a DVD drive is not present in your system, then use a USB drive. If, however, you do not have a USB DVD drive, you can use the Virtual Media method. If you want to use the Virtual Media method, then you need to have the Microsoft Windows Server 2012 R2 ISO image ready in your system. In this video, we will be using the virtual media method for installation. Next, click Deploy OS. If the virtual disk is not present, you'll be redirected to the RAID configuration wizard to create a virtual disk. Select Configure RAID first to create a new virtual disk. You can also select this option to edit the attributes of an existing virtual disk. If the virtual disk is already present, select Go directly to OS Deployment and then click Next. Under Available Systems, select Microsoft Windows 2012 R2 and then click Next. Note, if the available options do not list Windows Server 2012 R2, then you have to download the latest OS driver pack from dell.com/support and update the drivers on the server before you restart the installation by using the Lifecycle Controller. The system loads the relevant drivers for the selected OS. This will take less than 5 minutes to compose the OS drivers. Select Manual Install as the installation mode and then click Next. On the Insert OS Media page, click Virtual Media and then click Map CD-DVD to map the device. In the Virtual Media Map CD-DVD dialog box, click Browse to select the Microsoft Windows 2012 R2 ISO image and then click Map Device. Validating the operating system media will take less than 2 minutes. The settings are summarized on this page. Click Finish to apply the settings. Once the settings have been applied, the system will reboot and start the OS deployment. After rebooting the OS, you'll be prompted to press any key to start the installation. If the key is not pressed, then the system does not proceed with the installation. Once you press any key, the OS installation starts. Once the files are loaded, select the appropriate language in which you want to install the OS. If, however, you want to change to another language, reboot the system and boot to the OS media, and then choose the desired language. You can select the time and currency format of your region, select keyboard or input method, and then click Next. And click Install Now. This operation might take a while to complete. Note. If you want to install the GUI version, then select Windows Server 2012 R2 Data Center, Server with GUI, and click Next. Read the license agreement. If you agree to the license terms, select I accept the license terms, and then click Next. Select Custom, Install Windows Only. Click New, and then click Apply. Click OK. Now drive partitions are created. After this, select the drive where you want to install Microsoft Windows 2012 R2, and then click Next to begin the installation. Note that the system will restart a few times while the installation is in progress. After the installation is successful, the system restarts. Once the system restarts, you have to set the password for the default username administrator. You can now log in to Windows Server 2012 R2 using the administrator credentials. Note. The Dell highly recommends that you install the latest hotfixes and security updates from Microsoft on your system by using Windows updates or by downloading the latest updates after installing the operating system. For more information, go to dellteccenter.com/OS.